Have you ever wondered why the wristwatch strapped to your arm, your mobile screen, or any other clock in the world shows 12 numbers signifying 12 hours? Why isn't it some other random number like 28 or 16? What is the significance of 12 in our perception of time? Well, 24 hours are divided into two parts, a day lasting 12 hours and a night lasting 12 hours. 1 hour contains 60 minutes, each of which contains 60 seconds each. Each second is then divided into 1,000 milliseconds. Now, that seems like a rather strange way to divide a day. No wonder kids have trouble learning how to tell time. However, as always, like every other thing in the world, there is a reason behind this too. In today's world, we widely use the decimal number system, a system believed to have originated because it made it easy for us to count things on our fingers. Back then, when humans were still exploring the wonders of nature, and finding answers to their countless questions, many other numerical systems were commonly used. The Egyptians and Babylonians who first divided the day into smaller parts used duodecimal or base 12 and sexagesimal or base 60 numeral systems. As mentioned, the structure of our fingers is precisely the reason for our base 10 system. The number of joints on each hand makes it possible to count to 12 by using our thumb. Now, the 24-hour day concept comes from the ancient Egyptians. They divided the day into 10 hours with devices like shadow clock, and then added 1 hour at each end, one for twilight and one at the end of the day. However, the absence of sunlight made it difficult to divide the time at night. In those ancient times, with no sophisticated technology, they instead chose 36 star groups called decan, which rose consecutively on the horizon as the Earth rotated. Each decan rose before sunrise and marked the beginning of a 10-day period. A total of 36 decans thus led to 36 times 10, equaling 360 days per year. From one twilight to another, 18 of these decans were visible. However, each twilight period had 3 of these decans assigned, leaving 12 for the period of complete darkness. Thus, the rise of each decan marked an hour, so we ended up with 12 hours in each night. However, at that time, the hours did not have a fixed length. Then, Hipparchus gave us the equinoctial hours by proposing the division of a day into 24 equal hours. Even then, for a long time, ordinary people kept using the seasonally varying hours. It wasn't until the 14th century, when mechanical clocks came into use in Europe, that commoners began using the system we still have today. The Greek astronomers who helped us make life simpler by equally dividing 24 hours followed the Babylonians' base 60 system for astronomical calculations. They further divided an hour into 60 minutes and each minute into 60 seconds. Basically, the elegant ideas of our ancestors still rule our day-to-day lives thousands of years later. Now, go out there and flaunt your newly increased knowledge of time and make the best use of it.